Hello and welcome to this tutorial on paths testing in software testing and basis paths testing in software engineering. I will give an example in detail so that you may clearly understand path testing. So please view this tutorial until the end. What is path testing? In software testing and software engineering, basis paths testing, or simply paths testing, is a structured testing methodology. Paths testing is a structured testing methodology means that it is based on mathematics, specifically linear algebra, but that maths is not covered in this tutorial. Paths testing in software testing methodologies belongs to structured testing methodologies, but there are other software testing methodologies like requirements-based testing. So we can say that paths testing is complementary to requirements-based testing. Paths testing is a white box, meaning source code based test design technique to generate tests. Paths testing is mostly done by developers or software testers, and paths testing is done to the source code. Paths testing techniques use the control flow graph of a program or algorithm. You will soon see an example control flow graph. The control flow graph represents the program or algorithm unit. We use the control flow graph to find independent paths of execution using the cyclomatic complexity metric. The cyclomatic complexity is just a number that measures the decision logic in the program unit. You have to remember that cyclomatic complexity is the minimum number of tests required for the program unit. Path testing then generates tests for each path of execution. Path testing versus branch testing. Basis path testing is more thorough than branch testing. In branch testing, tests every decision outcome. There is something called happy path testing. What is happy path testing? A happy path means a path of execution with no errors, resulting in a positive outcome. For example, if you're making an online bill payment with the correct OTP, that results in a successful transaction. That would be a happy path testing. Path testing basics in software testing. This is the path testing process. We first design control flow graph, then calculate the cyclomatic complexity using the formula. It's a simple formula. Generate the set of paths and then test each path. Now let us see path testing in software testing with example. The example is path testing for triangle problem. On the web, I found complex algorithms for triangle problem. So I just wrote my own simple algorithm that I can fit on a slide. Now here I have listed the algorithm. On the first column, we have the steps and the actual statements of the algorithm are in the second column. Now this triangle problem is, if we get three sides of a triangle, A, B and C, then we have to determine whether these three sides together can result in a triangle or cannot result in a triangle, and if they can result in a triangle, whether it is an equilateral triangle, which means all three sides are equal, or it's an isosceles triangle, meaning any two sides are equal but not all three sides, or it's a scalene triangle, meaning that the three sides are different. So step one is that there are three sides, input A, B and C, and the assumption I'm making is that each side is greater than zero. So step two basically checks whether side A is greater than the sum of the other two sides. If that is the case, it cannot be a triangle. Same with side B. If it is greater than or equal to the sides A and C, then it can never be a triangle. And same with side C. If it's greater than or equal to A plus B, then it's not a triangle. Now, as we saw that the first step in the path testing is to design the control flow graph. So let us design the control flow graph. So here I have the control flow graph for this particular program unit or algorithm unit. Now, path testing criteria is that the program unit or algorithm unit should have exactly one entry node and exactly one exit node. So here 1 is the entry node and 10 is the exit node. And these numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and so on correspond to the steps in my algorithm. So step 1 corresponds to this step here. Input the sides A, B and C. The control flow graph from 1, it can move to 2, which means step 2. So step 2 is a decision. So here the decision is that A, if A greater than or equal to B plus C, etc., then it goes to step 3, and step 3 generates the final output, which is not a triangle. And from step 3, it moves directly to step 10, because the other statements are else if, and else. So one path of execution can be 1, 2, 3, and 10. We will see each one of these paths in detail. We have the cyclomatic complexity formula. Cyclomatic complexity, CC, is E minus N plus 2. What is E? E is the number of edges. These are the edges from 1 to 2, 2 to 4, 4 to 5, etc. The edges represent the control flow between nodes. And what are the nodes? These are the nodes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 through 10. These are the nodes. The nodes represent expressions or statements that need to be executed. Since the formula for cyclomatic complexity is E minus N plus 2, then we have to find out what is the total number of edges in this control flow graph. So we can count it. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. So there are 12 edges in this control flow graph. So we can replace E with 12. Then N is the number of nodes. So here you can see there are nodes from 1 through 10. So N is replaced by 10 plus 2. 12 minus 10 plus 2 gives us 4. So here cyclomatic complexity is 4. So basically, cyclomatic complexity is a minimum number of tests required for the program unit or algorithm unit. So we need a minimum of 4 tests in order to test this algorithm. Now let us see each of these test paths of execution one by one. The first possibility is that it's not a triangle. So let us generate the path of execution for that. Let us say that the sides A, B and C are 10, 5 and 4. It goes to step 2. In step 2, 10 greater than or equal to 5 plus 4. 5 plus 4 is 9, which means one side is greater than the sum of the other two sides. Output is not a triangle. And from step 3, it goes to step 10. So here, the path of execution in the control flow graph is 1, 2, step 2 to step 3 to step 10. And here we can see, not a triangle example, the side A was 10, B was 5 and C was 4. These three sides can never make a triangle. So the output is, it's not a triangle. Now let us see another possibility. Now here, the possibility is for equilateral triangle in which the three sides are equal, and let us generate the path of execution. Here the three sides A, B and C are 5, 5 and 5. If 5 greater than or equal to 5 plus 5, no, and it's the same condition here. So it skips step 3, goes to step 4, then it checks 5 is equal to 5. So first two sides are the same and 5 is equal to 5. The second and third side are the same. Then the output is equilateral triangle and it goes to step 10. So here in the control flow graph, the path of execution is step 1 to 2, 4, 5 and 10. So this is another independent path of execution. Note that in different paths of execution, some of the nodes may still be executed. And here is an example of the equilateral triangle. We had the three sides, A was 5, B was 5 and C was 5. With these three sides, we can make an equilateral triangle in which all the sides are the same. Another possibility is isosceles triangle, in which any two sides but not all the three sides are the same. Let us generate the path of execution. Let us say A, B and C are 8, 6 and 6. So it checks 8 greater than or equal to 6 plus 6. No, 8 is not greater than or equal to 12. 6 greater than or equal to 8 plus 6. No, 6 greater than or equal to 8 plus 6. No. So it goes to step 4. It checks if the two sides are the same. 8 is equal to 6. No. So it just skips because it's an AND condition. It goes through step 6. 8 is equal to 6. No. 8 is equal to 6. No. 6 is equal to 6. Yes. It's an OR condition. So it becomes true. Output becomes isosceles triangle. And it goes to step 10. Here we can see the control flow graph. From step 1, it went to 2, 4, 6, 7 and 10. This is another independent path of execution. Here is an example of the isosceles triangle. We had the three sides. A was 8, B was 6 and C was 6. So it makes an equilateral triangle in which the sides B and C are of the same length. The last possibility is that it's a scalene triangle, meaning that all three sides are different. So let us generate the path of execution in the control flow graph. In step 1, let us say that the sides A, B and C are 7, 8 and 5. It goes to step 2. 7 greater than or equal to 8 plus 5? No. 8 greater than or equal to 7 plus 5? No. 5 greater than or equal to 7 plus 8? No. So none of the conditions is true. It goes to step 4. 7 is equal to 8? No. And this is an AND condition, so it can skip the remaining expressions. Go to step 6. 7 is equal to 8? No. 7 is equal to 5? No. 8 is equal to 5? No. Then none of the conditions is true. So it goes to step 8. This is just an else. And in step 9, output is the scalene triangle. And it goes to step 10. So here is the control flow graph, path of execution. It goes from step 1 to 2, 4, 6, 8, 9 and 10. So these were the four paths of execution that we have. And the scalene triangle example is that we have three sides, 7, 8 and 5, and the three sides are all different and it's a scalene triangle. So let us revisit the path testing process. First, we have to design the control flow graph. Then calculate the cyclomatic complexity metric, which is E minus N plus 2, where E is the number of edges and N is the number of nodes. So here in our triangle problem example, we got the cyclomatic complexity as 4. Then we generate the set of paths. In our triangle problem, there were 4 set of paths. And the final step is to test each path. This completes my basis path testing example. I hope that now you know the basic concepts of path testing. Please view my other test design tutorials also. Thank you.